going to study force exerted by a jet on a stationary plate. So we are having a jet, and this jet is impinging on this plate, and this plate is stationary. And let us assume that this jet is moving with the velocity v. And now we know force is equal to rate of change of momentum. So if we are able to find this change in momentum, and we will be dividing it with the time to get force. Now let the mass of water or the jet impinging on plate be m, and we already know the velocity is v. This is the initial momentum. Now in order to find the final momentum, we know this velocity is in this direction shown by this arrow. After impinging on the plate, the water is splitting in such a way that the motion will be upward and downward direction. So there is no velocity in the same direction as the previous velocity. So the final velocity will be zero. So that the final momentum is equal to m into zero divided by time. That is mv by t. Now m by t is a mass per unit time, that is discharge. So discharge can be written as, so discharge is equal to mass by time. That mass is equal to rho into volume by time, and this volume is equal to rho into volume means area of cross section of this jet, that is A, into length, the total length of the water impinging on it. So rho into A into L divided by time. Now L by T, that is length of jet divided by time, that is actually velocity of jet. So that is equal to rho into A into V. Now if we are substituting this rho AV in place of M by T, we will get it is equal to rho A V square. That is the force with which the jet impinges on the stationary plate is given by the equation rho A V square.